I'm Anirudh and this is Shamona. We're from Class 11, PSBB Learning Leadership Academy. And we're here today strongly against the statement, love is the occupation of the unintelligent.
A very good afternoon to one and all present here. I'm Rashi and this is my partner Prithvi. And we are strongly for the statement that love is an occupation for the unintelligent people.
Good afternoon to everyone. I am Kathija Lubna.
And I am Gulsha Mariam. We are from Besant Women's College, Mangaluru. We are strongly against the statement, love is an occupation of unintelligence.
Love and compassion are the highest form of intelligence. Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, one of India's greatest presidents, researchers, scientists and philanthropists. Now, what we aim to result in the premise of this debate is that love and intelligence are synonymous. Let's take an example of Dr. APJ Abdul Kalam, who loved our country so much, he gave to the poor, and yet we cannot say that he wasn't intelligent. Love is a part of our lives, it is prevalent in what we do, what we say, and the very instinct of a human being is love.
Now, what we have to understand is, despite what the media tells us, there's more than one kind of love. Romantic love between a man and a woman is not the only kind of love. There are other types of love. The love between a son and his mother, the love between a person and his country. And these types of love matter too. Whether it be Jeff Bezos, Bill Gates, Einstein, Stephen Hawking, or even Mahatma Gandhi, all of them had love as the driving force.
Time up.
Thank you.
Okay, now what exactly is love? Now when an individual falls in love in the other person, he starts to expect things, he starts to demand things. And when those demands are not fulfilled, that particular person gets angry.
And sometimes we see cases where people commit suicides or give harm to their own physical self, or he might get into depression and anxiety. Such things that that affect our mental and emotional effects also.
So do you think that is intelligent? That is completely unintelligent. And when they told about love for your country, I'll tell you, love for your country also bought the world war.
And also when we say love is a part of life, exactly, love is a part of life, not a whole life, that you create unintelligent decisions and create mess in your own life.
The best love is the love which awakens the soul, which makes us strong and stay wise.
Best kind of love sets our mind on peace, and so many things cannot be done by someone who is dumb and cannot match our intellectual level. And I would like to give my opinion on what my friends in team B said. They said they see suicides in the case of love, but it's the individual's choice. If they are smart enough, they wouldn't do that. They will come over that and they will find a new way to live their life happily. So intelligence is needed when you're in love with someone.
So team B stated about how love leads to expectations and how that leads to anger and conflict. But from when are expectations bad? As a society, we've progressed only because of expectation and competition. The very reason we're here debating as a competition is because of our love for debate. Are you saying that here we're doing something unintelligent just because we like oration? Secondly, Elon Musk and other great people who created technology did it for their love. They have reduced carbon emissions, carbon dioxide, and they're helping the poverty too, all because of love.
And we also have to understand that just like there are many types of love, there are also many types of intelligence. There is intelligence beyond the plain logical and rational intelligence. There is emotional intelligence. Intelligence has a multidimensional factor that has to be considered as well. Love itself is a form of intelligence. And also, when we say humans are irrational, make irrational decisions because of love, there are many reasons why humans make irrational decisions. Hate, greed, love. But at the end of the day, it's these irrational decisions that make us human.
Time up.
Okay, I'd like to contradict my worthy opponent, Team A. They said that you are here for the love of debate. I'll tell you, I'm intelligent enough. I'm here for debate because I want the money that is a crash price. And also, next thing, the thing you told about love for the mother and son. Okay, now when the mother is too much obsessive about the son, he won't let him go outside and study. That would restrict him to learn new things. So that is an occupation of an unintelligent person.
Sometimes we over pamper our own children, saying that we love and all that. It makes it very difficult for them to even adjust outside their comfort zone. Second of all, according to a survey conducted, and when people were asked, when was the first love you had? They reportedly said 15 to 18 was the age when they had their first love. Now, you tell me, when people who are at the age of 15 to 18, who are still hitting their puberty and don't have a proper mentality of how stable the thought process that they have, how can you say that they're tagging infatuation to be love? Taima, how can you say they're intelligent enough?
Suppose you have a person A. You're trying to make a conversation with that person, but you're not able to because that person cannot match up to your intellectual level. He or she cannot understand your thoughts, cannot process them. Then how are you going to fall in love with them? You need the same intellectual level to fall in love with a person. Now leave aside romantic love. Let's be practical. You can hold your own thoughts, but the other person cannot. Then you cannot fall in love with that person, be it your boyfriend, girlfriend, mother, father, or anyone. You will love your parents, but the kind of love which comes with intellectual level is different.
Now, I'm sure a lot of people have done a lot of stupid things in the name of love. Violence, murder, so many various things. But the thing is, just because some people commit bad decisions in the name of love, doesn't mean that love is restricted to the unintelligent people. Smart people show love as well in smart ways.
I would like to reiterate that there are many types of love and cannot be secluded or sidelined between two people. The very instinct of a child right when it's born is love. It learns through love of its mother, and people learn good things through love. Now, if you're going to look at the flip side of the coin and look at the small minority of bad things, every sample population has them. And to look at the majority is to learn how love is an inherent part of our lives and will truly shape how intelligent we are.
Okay, first of all, you accepted that there are some people who commit crimes. That means you're accepting the statement, what I'm trying to say. Okay, and the next thing is that when you're talking about movies in our country, there are movies like DDLJ where people go and watch it. I know there are tons of people watching it. When you talk about movies like Parmanu, where there is a lot of intelligence, where there is history, nobody wants to watch it because the audience which is watching the movies is unintelligent.
And if you're stating that a small part of people are committing crime something, if you're basically stating that everything is love and fair and war, then my dear worthy opponent, you're also stating that everything that happens, for example, the rapes and all that, they are justified just because everything is fair in love and war. That is totally unintelligent.
With love comes power, intellectual freedom and wisdom.
Taking the example of our present day, in our society, some men cannot digest the fact that women are rising higher than them in position, in ranks, or whatsoever it is. That is because of lack of intelligence. They cannot digest the fact that they are earning more. The love starts evaporating when they see the women going higher than them. So, the love intelligence empowers love. You need intelligence. Only intelligent people can digest the fact that someone else is rising higher in power than them, even though they love them.
Now, we accept that unintelligent people make bad decisions when it comes to money, and intelligent people tend to make smarter decisions when it comes to money. Similarly, unintelligent people tend to make worse decisions when it comes to love, whereas intelligent people tend to make smarter decisions when it comes to love. Love is something that is common to all humans. It's a biological urge that has driven humans since the very beginning of our existence.
In round 2, Team B stated, and I quote, that people do bad things because of love. And in round 3, they said that not everyone does bad things, and in this way, they're rebutting their own points. Lastly, we would like to conclude that love is here to stay. Love is a biological urge that people are born with. Love teaches people, people learn from love, and love is just a synonym for intelligence.
Whether it be smart, dumb, male, female, or anyone of any color, race, caste, gender, love empowers all.
My worthy opponent, Team A, I'd like to clearly state you that you stated the point and not me. You told that there are some people who do that, even in love. And also talking about the Honorable Prime Minister, even he has sacrificed love with his wife and his mother for the nation. Correct? So we are talking about, you know, love being an occupation of the unintelligent. Because the Prime Minister is intelligent, he's done that.
See great wonders that he is doing for the nation that people couldn't do in the last 70 years. And to conclude with our debate, we would like to say that love is useless without a mind that is blind.
Love is all about care, kindness and humility. World needs all of it. So we cannot term it as dumb or unintelligent.
Intelligence breeds love. Stupidity breeds disdain. No one has ever fallen in love with unintelligence. They always go look for someone who stands out in a group of people, that is intelligent people. So people who are intelligent fall in love with intelligent people because they respect them. Intelligence is the essence of life and it uses love to extract ways of livelihood. And we are strongly against the statement that love is an occupation of unintelligence. Thank you.